Hello, folks. What is up? This is Michael on the Graveyard Shift in the wee hours of the night with your daily trivia question. Once again, to get your day started, I hope everything is going well for you. I hope you're safe and healthy. I don't know, folks, at some point in time yesterday, we hit like a brick wall getting over that hump in hump day. And the week, it just came to a screeching crawl. I thought we were going to fly through this week, but apparently it's just going to creep. But nevertheless, I'm thankful that it's Thursday and not Wednesday, and I'm looking forward to Friday, that's for sure. All right, so we will just keep on going. That's all we can do. The answer to the previous trivia question was none other than Vanessa Williams. So Vanessa Lynn Williams initially gained recognition. First of all, I don't know if you've heard this story or not. I mean, some of you all who didn't live through the 80s or weren't born yet, you may not have heard of this story. It's kind of unfortunate and sad. It deals with Vanessa Williams and the Miss America pageant. So she initially gained recognition as the first African-American woman to receive the Miss America title when she was crowned Miss America for 1984. Now, everyone relished in this accomplishment. It was a big deal, and she set out on her journey as the reigning Miss America for that year. She did public events, photo ops. She met with President Reagan that year. I remember this. It was a big, big deal. She went and raised money for charities, for her causes, and so forth. Then a scandal of sorts broke out later that year, however, when she learned that Penthouse magazine would publish nude photographs of her in an upcoming issue. As a result of this, and when the pageant committee found out, Williams was asked to relinquish her title by the directors of the pageant. In doing so, the pageant's executive committee voted unanimously. There was no exception to this for it at all, for Williams' resignation. And they stated, quote, "We have today asked Miss Williams to relinquish her crown and the title of Miss America 1984. We will give her 72 hours to give that request consideration." So basically they gave her an ultimatum. They just laid it out on the line, just as bold as they could be. And this was this is the catch to the whole thing. This was just a few weeks prior to the end of her reign. So she only had a few weeks left when this scandal broke. Now, remember, this is the 1980s. Okay, this is groundbreaking. Her accomplishments in and of itself were groundbreaking. So we've never dealt with this before. This is the first time in the 63-year history of the pageant that they'd had to deal with something like this. So when it broke, it was a scandal, and it was a big deal, and it broke all over the place nationally. And after being chased around by the paparazzi, when, as you can imagine, when the scandal broke up and she chose to resign among mixed public and media opinions, it was kind of 50-50 split. You know, people were felt sorry for her, sympathized with her, and some just blamed her outright and didn't have any sympathy with her whatsoever. Now check this out. 32 years later, in September of 2015, this is pretty recent, Williams would go on to serve as the head judge for the Miss America 2016 pageant. And at that event, former Miss America CEO Sam Haskell called her out on stage and made a public apology to her for the events of 1984. So it took 32 years, but she finally got an apology. All right. A couple of geek factoids about this very unique, historic, and just kind of a strange kind of a case, if you will. Penthouse maintained their position that they had what they called release forms signed by Williams at the time. That's always been up for debate. No, I don't think they were able to ever really physically produce those. They paid a lot of money for the pictures, and they blamed the pageant. They said, you know, this whole scandal type of an aspect isn't on us. It's because of the pageant. The pageant isn't very open, you know, and things like this. So they tried to put it on the pageant when the whole thing broke, and they were interviewed about it. She is the only Miss America who has been asked to resign in the pageant's history, and I don't think that's ever been that's ever been repeated. Williams is a little some unknown things about Vanessa Williams. She's an accomplished. She went on to do amazing things. She's an accomplished singer. She's an accomplished actress. She's been in movies, TV shows, too many to list, quite frankly. She's received multiple nominations for Grammys. She received a nomination for a Tony Award, a couple of Primetime Emmys. She's been on Broadway. So it's not like she just took this and disappeared somewhere. She just kept trudging on, pounding the pavement, and kept working. Good for her. In March of 2016, Williams launched her own clothing line. Not an easy thing to pull off. It's called V by Vanessa Williams. The 1985 Penthouse issue that contained the spread of Vanessa Williams was one of the most anticipated and top-selling publications of the magazine ever. I remember when this broke. I was a kid, of course, but everybody wanted to know who had the Penthouse magazine. How could you get it? It was a top seller. And just for giggles, I looked at some of the top-selling kind of websites like Amazon, eBay, and I found it listed, believe it or not, in the worst, most horrible condition an old magazine could come in for $85. That was today. I found that listed for $85. So there you go. If you happen to have $85 and you want that Penthouse magazine, it is available. There you go. I have seen over the years. I have seen the Penthouse spread of Vanessa Williams, and it is a little dicey. It is very, very, it's Penthouse worthy. I'm gonna put it to you that way. But there you go. That's the 1984 controversial Vanessa Williams Miss America scandal. All right, folks, check this out. This is a pretty popular event for this trivia question. Let's see if you can get this and you remember this from your history. For July 21st, on this day in 1925, and long before the O.J. Simpson murder trial, this trial of the century about teaching evolution in public schools came to a close in Tennessee with a conviction for the school teacher that the trial was named after. Good luck. Have a thankful Thursday, folks. I'm thankful for you all. Thanks for all you do. I'll see you next time. Tomorrow's Friday. Peace out.